write a C++ program to implement BubbleSort. In BubbleSort algorithm, in order to sort n number of values, we need to perform n minus 1 number of passes. During each pass, it will compare the elements, adjacent elements, and if the elements are of bigger size, it needs to be swapped towards the right-hand side. So after the first pass, the most highest element will get stored at the last position of the array. During the second pass, the second highest element will get stored at the second last position of the array. Likewise, during each pass, we will find out the highest element, and that will be shifted ahead to become part of the last part of the sorted array. So if there are 5 number of elements that need to be sorted, then we have to perform 4 number of passes. So during the first pass, the highest number of elements will get stored at the last place. During the second pass, the second highest element will get stored at the second last place, and so on. In order to write the logic for the bubble sort, we are writing a method which is named as bubble sort. The first parameter is an array which needs to be sorted, and n indicates the total number of elements present in the array A. So here we are using for loop. In order to repeat the number of passes, the index variable k is used to indicate the number of passes we have to perform. So 0 to n minus 1. So the number of values which k takes will be 0 to n minus 2. So total n minus 1 number of passes. So during each pass, the how many number of elements need to be compared, that is indicated by using another index variable I. So during the first pass, if the value of n is 5, the index I should goes up to 3. So that is why we have written I is less than n minus k minus 1. So during each time when we take an element, always we have to start taking the element starting from 0. That is why we have written the value of I starting from 0. And it keep on decreasing depending on the number of passes. That's why we have written n minus k minus 1. So each element will be compared with the adjacent element. If the first element is greater than the second element, it will get swapped. Similarly, if the second element is greater than the third element, it will be swapped. Finally, during the first pass, the highest element will get at the last position of the array. Similarly, during the second pass, the second highest element will get stored at the second last place of the array. Next, we are defining a swap method for swapping two values by call by reference, because we are passing the array element. So ai and ai plus 1, those element will get swapped by using the formal parameters x and y. Next, we are defining a display method for displaying the value of a particular array. It takes two parameters. First parameter is the array. Second parameter is the number of elements present in the array. By using a for loop, we are displaying the elements which are present in the array. We are using an index variable I that ranges from 0 to n minus 1. In the main method, in order to call this bubble sort function, we are first declaring an array variable with some initialized value which are not in proper sorted order. Before performing the sorting operations, we display the values which are present in the array x by calling the method display. So display method takes two parameters. First one is the array name x, and second the number of values which are present in x, which is 10. After that, we are calling bubble sort method. Here first parameter is the array name x, and second is the number of elements present in the array. After performing the sorting operation, the sorted array will get stored into the variable x because it is passed by using array reference. So the array can be displayed once again after calling the bubble sort method by display method. Execute and see the program output. Thank you for watching this tutorial.